intravascular pressure monitoring setup with the TruWave transducer. Part 2, calibration. Before connecting the TruWave transducer to a bedside monitor and calibrating the system, it's important to prime the system properly. If you haven't already done so, please follow the steps in Part 1 of this video series, Priming the System, to complete this procedure. Now that we have completed priming the system, we will need to calibrate the TruWave transducer with the bedside physiologic monitor using the following 8 steps. Step 1. Connect the appropriate TruWave reusable pressure cable to the proper port on the bedside monitor. Then, connect the opposite end of the reusable cable to the TruWave transducer's white connecting cable. Step 2. For intravascular pressure monitoring, level the transducer to the patient's phlebostatic axis, which can be found at the midpoint between the anterior and posterior chest wall at the 4th intercostal space. Note, it's important to maintain the level of the transducer with the phlebostatic axis at all times while monitoring to ensure accurate pressure readings. It is a best practice recommendation to use a carpenter's level when leveling the transducer. Step 3. The TruWave transducer must be zeroed to remove the effects of atmospheric pressure. Open the stopcock above the transducer to atmospheric air by turning the stopcock toward the patient's pressure tubing and away from the TruWave transducer. Then remove the non-vented cap. Perform this maneuver while maintaining sterility of the cap and stopcock port. Step 4. Select the zero function on the bedside monitor and confirm that the monitor's pressure channel waveform and numeric value display zero. Check monitor calibration using the procedure recommended by the monitor manufacturer. Step 5. Close the stopcock on the TruWave transducer toward the vent port and then return the non-vented cap. Step 6. If not already connected, connect the TruWave's pressure tubing to the patient's catheter. Step 7. Confirm the appropriate pressure waveform and numeric values are present. Step 8. Perform a square wave test to assess the frequency response of the system by pulling the snap tab and releasing quickly. Please be advised that poor dynamic response can be caused by air bubbles, clotting, excessive lengths of tubing, excessively compliant pressure tubing, small bore tubing, loose connections, or leaks. Confirm the pressure channel has the appropriate label, scale, alarm settings, and color coding for physiologic pressure being measured. The calibration procedure is now complete. The TruWave disposable pressure transducer is designed with the clinician in mind, from its ergonomic profile that fits in the palm of your hand to its cable connector that attaches and disconnects easily. TruWave disposable pressure transducers can also be paired with a Vamp Plus kit or a Vamp kit. The venous arterial blood management protection system for a complete and reliable closed, needleless blood sampling system with accurate pressure readings in one complementary unit. Please see our website for additional demonstrations of the Vamp systems. At Edwards Life Sciences, everything we do is focused on providing the clear information you need, how you need it, in the moments you need it most.